lady leave. Come with me, I know the way. She says it's down, down, down the dark ladder. Do you wanna contact somebody? Leave someone a letter. You can come.
guy that used to sit on the corner of 8th and 6th Avenue in New York City and play clarinet really fantastically. And one day I came by the corner where he usually was playing. He was sitting there with dark glasses on and a tag around his neck which said, "I am blind." And he was begging in the street. He wasn't blind, but... he sure could play. So next time I saw him, he was sitting on the same corner and a little sign around his neck and it said, "My clarinet was broken in a crowd jostling and I am without a clarinet. Please contribute." So I bought him a brand new shiny clarinet, which he immediately hawked. And the next day I went by that corner and there was still no music there, but oh, there are people playing on corners all over the place, all over the world, who play really good. Thank you. I got a lot of new songs to play for you. This is another one. This is called The Banquet. I wrote it up where I'm living now, in Canada, north of Vancouver, you know, which is a very kind of serene place for the moment, you know. It's right on the sea, and it's pretty calm. There are a few motorboats in the summer, but it hasn't gotten like Walden Pond yet, you know. People lying around there, all greased up, and water skiing. Still pretty tranquil existence. I guess it comes from the Appalachian Mountains originally. There's all kind of controversy on where it came from before then. So let's just say it's like a truly American instrument made in Canada.
I
life is our cost. When I think of your kisses, my nine seesaws, do you see, do you see, do you see how you hurt me, baby? So I hurt you too. Then we both get so blue. couple of years ago, I traveled to Greece with a friend of mine, and we ended up on the island of Crete in a village called Matala, where there were a lot of caves, a lot of people living in the caves there, and it looked like one of those apartment buildings, you know, like sort of a Flintstone-esque apartment building with lights all over, you know, like, it was really incredible. There were about 4 or 5 different levels of caves, and some of them were underwater because the whole island was tilting every year, you know, it was just sort of sloping down. We stood up to this one big communal cave that was called the Hilton, and sit around and sing at night and enjoy exotic seafood dishes cooked up and passed around and eaten with the hands, and guaranteed to bring dysentery and other social wonderful existence. In the 2 weeks that I was actually longer than that, about 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks that I was there, we managed to pollute the well, and everybody was saying, "Oh, you know, Johnny, we're really going back to the garden. We're really going back to the garden." And every morning for breakfast, they would run down to the village to the bakery lady, who was kind of the mother figure, and they would have some yogurt and they would have some fresh baked bread, and they'd lay their drachma on the counter, you know, and they'd say, "Boy, you're really living off the land, you know." And then Easter rolled around, and of course they began killing lambs, you know, and hanging them up around in front of the stores. And a lot of these kids from New York and Philadelphia who'd never seen meat that wasn't in saran wrap were just a little squeamish about the whole existence. The first day Penelope and I got there, we arrived with creases down the front of our blue jeans from the dry cleaners, and we were kind of ostracized from the locals, tourists we were called, until we started to get a little baggy, you know. And we had this picnic in front of the Delfini restaurant the first night we were there. Penelope doesn't eat her crust of bread, you know, she leaves the crust. And I don't eat orange peel, so when we were finished, we had a little bit of litter, and we just didn't want to throw it all over the beach, in spite of the fact that it was already pretty well littered with Mickey Mouse chocolate bar wrappers and old yogurt containers. So I said, "Well, you know, let's maybe there's a litter barrel in the Delfini restaurant." So we walked in there, and there was this record playing, this old Beatle record. It was worn really thin. There hardly any grooves left on it, and it was on a battery-operated record player, and the batteries were almost gone. You hear the strains of "Sweet Little Darling, Don't You Cry." It was going up and down, you know, all over the place. It was really strange. And stranger than that was the man standing behind the counter in there, who several days later blew himself up lighting the kerosene stove. Not really blew himself up, he just kind of singed himself pretty good. Loud explosion and came blowing through the door of the Delfini. With his white turban on and a little gold heart in one ear and little loop in the other. So I walked up to this strange guy with the fiery red beard and the red hair and the little gold heart in one ear and the little loop in the other and the white turban all turned around, kind of gray, white turban. And I said, "Listen, you know, what are we going to do with this litter, man? We don't want to leave it on the beach, you know." And with this really intense look in his eyes and amazingly intense brow from a lot of deep thinking, you know, he took it out of my hands and, staring deep into my eyes, he threw it all over the floor. So for his birthday, I bought him 10 Mickey Mouse chocolate bars. That had 8 cards that he didn't have for trading. And I made him this song, which goes, "Oh, you're a mean old daddy, but I sure like it." Last night I couldn't sleep. Oh, you know it sure is hard to leave you, but it's really not my fault. My fingernails are filthy, I've got beach tar on my feet, and I miss my green muffin and my fancy French cologne. Oh, Perry, get out your cane, I'll put on some silver. Ooh, you're a mean old daddy, but I like you, I like you fine. Come on to the Mermaid Cafe, and I will buy you a bottle of wine. And we'll laugh and toast to nothing and smash our empty glasses down. Let's have a round for these freaks and these soldiers, a round for these friends of mine. Let's have another round for my grand devil that keeps me in this tourist town. Oh, Carrie, get out your cane, I'll put on some silver. Ooh, you're a mean old daddy, but I like you. Maybe I'll go to Amsterdam now. Maybe I'll go to Rome. And rent me a grand piano and put some flowers round my room. Ah, let's not talk about fare-thee wells now. The night is a starry dome, and they're playing that statue rock and roll beneath the mantle of moon. Oh, Carrie, get out your cane, I'll put on some silver. Ooh, you're a mean old daddy, but I like you, 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 I like you. Last night I couldn't sleep. Oh, you know it's sure it's hard to leave, but it's really not my home. Maybe it's been too long a time since I was scrambling down in the street. Now they got me used to that clean white linen and that fancy French cologne. Oh, Carrie, get out your cane, I'll put on my final silver. Go to the Mermaid Cafe, have fun tonight. I said, ooh, you're a mean old daddy, but you're out of
sunshine in the morning. He's my fire, that's at the end of the day.
came upon a child of God. He was walking along the road, and asked him, I said, where are you going in this? He told me, he said, I'm going down to Yaskis Park. I'm gonna join him. Dedicate to any DJs that might be in the house. It's called, Oh Honey, You Turn Me On, I'm a Radio.
Diamond, now
I'm a country station, I'm a little bit corny, I'm a wild flower waving for you, broadcasting tower waving for you. And I'm sending you this signal here, I hope you can pick it up loud and clear. I know you don't like weed when you get bored so quick, when you whistle in your loving and kind. If you've got too many doubts, if there's no good reception for me, then tune me out. Cause honey, who needs the static? It hurts the head, and you wind up fatting, and the day goes dismal from the breakfast party to the sign of prayer. What a sorry face you get to wear. I'm gonna tell you again now, if you still listen there, oh honey, you turn me on. So if you're driving into town with a dark cloud above you, dialing the number who's bound to love. Off the sand, cause honey, the love's still flowing. It says forget it, but your heart's still smoking. Call me at the station, the lights are open. It's called For the Roses, and that comes from that old expression which goes, to run for the roses. You know what that's from, right? Horse racing. This beautiful horse comes running down to the end of the track, comes in first, you know, and the trainers are all there, and all the people with the tickets on him are cheering, yeah, that's my horse, you know. They put a big wreath of flowers around his neck and strut him around in front of the stands. And a couple of weeks later, he's out running and steps in a gopher hole. And they have to shoot him. Difference between race horses and some pop stars is that some pop stars shoot themselves. That's kind of a sad thing to say, isn't it? It's true, sad but true. So anyway, I was lying up there in Canada in the wilderness. Listening to the sound of the wind one night. With visions of racehorses in my head. Thank you.
heard it in the wind. I said, sounded like a pause. Did you get around resounding all your way up here? Seems like many dim years ago since I heard that face to face. Oh, seen you face to face, though tonight I can feel you here. Get these notes on butterflies and lilac sprays, and girls who just have to tell me they saw you somewhere. In some office sits a poet, and he trembles as he sings, and he asks some guy to circulate his soul around. On your mark, red ribbon runner, the caressing rev of motors finally tuned like fancy women in 30s evening gowns. Up the charts, off to the airport, your name's in the news, everything's first class, and the lights go down, and it's just you up there getting them to feel like that. The days when you used to sit and make up your tunes for love, pour your simple sorrow to the sound of energy. Now you're seen on giant screens and at parties for the press and for people who have slices of you from the company. They toss around your latest golden egg, speculation of who's to know what the next one in the nest will glitter for them so. Yes, I seem ungrateful with my teeth sunk in a hand that brings me things I really can't give up just yet. Now I sit up here, the critic, and they introduce some band, but they seem so much confetti looking at all my TV set. Oh, the power and the glory, just when you're getting a taste for worship, they start bringing out the hammers and the boards and the nails. Summer, no more shiny hard light. Just the arbutus rustling in the bumping of the logs, and the moon swept down black water like an empty
that I wrote in Philadelphia a few years ago now, halfway between the second fret and Joy and Larry Schreiber's house. And the other half of it on an airplane. To me, what Happy Trails to you is to Roy Rogers and Dale Evans.
I get so damn timid, not at all the spirit that And the sea. Joni loves you all and says goodnight. Thank you.